Dear members of the GMIS, ladies and gentlemen, the COVID-19 pandemic has hit people and the economy hard. The crisis will continue to profoundly shape our world over the coming months. As political leaders seek to make sure the economy will recover as fast as possible, we have to remind ourselves that the free market economy and economic competitiveness are not ends in themselves, but are intended for the well-being of people in Germany and the EU and all over the world. Democratic decision-making serves the purpose of delivering freedom and equality also in these hard times. Economy has to take into consideration the needs of all citizens, whether acting as employees or entrepreneurs, because they all need a solid basis for the welfare of their families and to succeed in achieving their personal goals. We can also regard the pandemic as an opportunity, as a driving force for economic and social development. To tackle the crisis, cooperation and solidarity are needed. Policymakers and society have to draw the right conclusions from this crisis. Together and in solidarity with all EU member states, we have to draw the right lessons from the crisis and give the impetus that is needed for economic recovery. Our presidency is guided by the motto, "Together for Europe's recovery." The main tasks lying ahead include, firstly, supporting the recovery of Europe's economy. Secondly, strengthening economic and social cohesion within the EU while paving the way for a digital, sustainable future together. With a view to the decarbonization of the gas sector, for example, the Federal Ministry for Economic Affairs and Energy attaches great importance to joint project by member states within the framework of the IPCEI on hydrogen. Pressing ahead with the hydrogen IPCEI is one of the priorities in the field of industrial policy as set out by the federal government's presidency program. During its presidency of the Council of the EU and beyond, Germany will advocate open markets as an essential part of the solution to the current challenges. With a view to overcoming the COVID-19 crisis, Germany believes that the EU has to oppose protectionist trends and strengthen free and rule-based trade. International cooperation, rule-based trade and open markets are a fundamental part of the response needed for the COVID-19 crisis. The industrial sector has a key role to play in the recovery of Europe's economy. We have to take stimulus measures and invest in forward-looking technologies that can safeguard long-term growth and prosperity. Under Germany's Council presidency, the Competitiveness Council is debating how the initiatives arising from the European Industrial Strategy can interact with measures for the recovery of Europe's economy. Making European industry greener, more digital, and more resilient is the main goal of our industrial policy. In order to achieve this goal, policymakers have to create the right environment, a level playing field for industry to be able to survive in the face of European and international competition and succeed through innovation. If the industrial sector is to become more independent and resilient, innovative and strategic value chains across Europe and key enabling technologies are of crucial importance. The experience of the COVID-19 pandemic will encourage European industry to reassess current supply chains in terms of their risk potential in order to be able to strengthen their resilience. Member states and the EU should consider how the instruments of single market policy, in addition to the trade policy toolbox, can be used to support industry in these efforts. This also includes further improving the conditions required for attracting industrial production to the EU. Even as we struggle with the COVID-19 crisis, we are determined to continue to promote and give new impetus to the energy transition. An important element of our hydrogen strategy is the approach of sector coupling. The purpose of sector coupling is to more closely integrate the electricity and heat, transport and industrial sectors. It provides a number of major benefits. For a large number of sectors that are difficult to electrify, sector coupling offers an indirect way to using electricity that has been generated from renewable sources of energy. Thus, it allows renewable energy to be used for the reduction of carbon emissions across all sectors. To ensure the long-term success of the energy transition and to make progress on climate change mitigation, we need alternatives to fossil fuels. As an extremely versatile source of energy, hydrogen is going to play a major role in this context. Hydrogen that is produced in a climate-friendly manner permits significant reductions in carbon emissions, particularly in industry and transport. As it implements its national hydrogen strategy, the federal government will create a reliable framework that supports innovation and investment in a sustainable energy system and economy. Ensuring the success of hydrogen technologies requires close cooperation with European and international partners. What the economy now needs is stimulus and investment, also at international level.